Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to remove the background from your photo, add a new background in, and make a template for YouTube thumbnails in Adobe Photoshop. All right, let's get started. First, you'll need to take a photo of yourself or a few photos on a solid background like a blank wall, like these photos. I know these are kind of dorky faces, but oh well. Anyway, so these are pictures that I took of myself. It's okay that there's a picture hanging on the wall. Photoshop can kind of tell what it should be focusing on. So I'm going to pull the first one of these into Photoshop, and then I'll come back out here to my Finder, and I'm going to drag the rest of these into the same document. I'll just hit Enter or Return to kind of commit them to the document. And now you can see in your Layers panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing some of these panels, you can come up here to Window. So you can go to Window Layers right here. So you can see that it's put each of them on its own layer. Now I'm going to hit W, which will bring me to this set of tools. We actually want the magic wand tool though. So navigate down to that one. And then we'll click on our first layer. Now, because we're on the magic wand tool, our control panel, which is right up here, will change, and we get the option to select subject. So I'm going to click on that, and it might think for a moment, but it's done a pretty good job of selecting me. So now I'm going to make a mask. And to do that, we'll come up here to Layer, Layer Mask, and Reveal Selection. I'm going to hold Option or Alt and click on the eyeball, and that will hide all of these other layers. So you can see that I'm completely cut out with just a click of a button. Now I'm going to hide this one and click on the next one. I'll do the same thing. I'll select subject, and then I'll come up here to Layer, Layer Mask, and Reveal Selection. Now I've actually set up a keyboard shortcut for this because I use it so often. If you want to do that, mine is Shift Option Command M, or Shift Alt Control M on a PC. But you can set it up to whatever you want. I'll show you how to do that real quick. You can go to Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts, then you'll click the drop down for Layer, scroll down to Layer Mask and Reveal Selection, and then just click in here. You can just hold down the keys that you want to add in there. And then we'll say okay. So I'm going to go ahead and use my shortcut instead of going to Layer, Layer Mask, and Reveal Selection for the rest of these. So I'll hide that one and show the next one, and I'll make sure I'm clicked on it. I'll select subject, and then I'll make the layer mask. And I'm going to do that with the other two, but I'll speed up the video so you don't have to sit through it. The reason this tool has worked so well is because I'm standing against a solid background. The Select Subject tool does really well in that situation. It's probably not going to work quite as well if you're standing in front of a tree with a bunch of leaves all over the place back there. That's why having a blank area behind you is important. Now, personally, I like to make my YouTube thumbnails in Illustrator because I like the way the text behaves more over there, but it's totally easy to make them here in Photoshop too, so that's what we're going to do today. So let's go ahead and change our document size to the size of a YouTube thumbnail, which is currently at 1280 by 720. So I'm going to come up here to the top and go to Image and Canvas Size. We'll change this to 1280 by 720. It should be pixels, and we'll say OK. And that is fine, so we'll proceed. And you'll see that all your photos are way too big for the tiny little canvas. So I'm going to turn all my layers back on. You can click on each one, or you can hold Option, Command, and Comma. That's Alt, Control, Comma on a PC. And now I'm going to hold Shift and select all of them at the same time. Now we're going to transform them. So we'll come up here to Edit and Free Transform. You can also hit Command T or Control T. And I'm going to resize these. I'm holding Option and Shift at the same time, or Alt and Shift on a PC. I'm just going to put them over here to the right. And I'll hit Enter or Return. Now I'm going to hold Alt or Option and click the eyeball so I can see what they look like on each layer. This one, I think I'll move it up a little bit. So I'll hit V to get my move tool. That looks good to me. And maybe this one I'll move over a little bit. So the placement of all of my photos is good now. Now I don't actually do this for my own YouTube thumbnails, but it's very popular to add a white outline around your body shape. That style is something you see a lot on YouTube these days. And you can do that here. First, I'm going to add a black background. So I'm going to add a new layer. I'll pull it to the bottom. I've got a black foreground color, but if you don't have that, just hit D on your keyboard, which should give you a black foreground and a white background. Then you can just hit Alt Delete or Option Delete. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. Now let's click on the showing layer. And there are two ways to do this. Usually if you have kind of frizzy hair like I do, it doesn't work very well to add a stroke to this layer, but I want to show you that way first. So we'll come down here to FX. We'll go to Stroke. And now you can see what I mean. I've got a stroke here. The size is 27. I've got it positioned outside, which is what you want. 100% opacity, and then you can click on the color and change the color of the outline here. So we'll say okay. The reason it doesn't look great is because I have all these wispy little hairs out here, and Photoshop is seeing them as pixels, so it's adding the outline all the way starting from about right here. And that is not what I want. So if this works for you, it is a faster way of doing it. But if it doesn't, I'll show you another way. So we'll get rid of this stroke. And I'm going to hold Alt or Option and click on my mask, which is right over here. Not on this part, but over here. And that'll show me just the mask part. I'm going to Command or Control click this to select it. And then I'll make a new layer. And I'm going to hide these other layers. Now I'll fill it with black, which is my foreground color, by hitting Option Delete or Alt Delete on a PC. And now you can really see what I was talking about with these little fuzzy pixels out here. So what we'll need to do to kind of get rid of those is to blur it and then sharpen it again. We'll come up here to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and I think 2.5 is pretty good. You can see it kind of blurs those together. We'll say okay. Then we'll come up here to do an unsharp mask. So Filter, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask. And for this one, I've already got these settings in because I was testing this the other day. So the ones that are working well for this are 323 amount and radius is 1000 and threshold is 0. So we'll say okay for that. And if we zoom in here, you can see that the edge is quite a lot more solid now. So let's come down here to FX and choose Stroke Now. Now this stroke is looking quite a lot nicer. It follows my body really well. And the size I'm using is 27 for the YouTube thumbnail. So now we'll bring this below the image that we are looking at. And we'll turn on the photo layer and the background image. And so this is what I was talking about, this kind of white outline that you see a lot on YouTube these days. Now it's not perfect. We have a little bit of weirdness through here, but I still think it looks good enough. If you want it to be absolutely perfect, you'll want to use the pen tool to trace around yourself and then make a path, select the path and fill that with a color and then add a stroke to it. But I'm not going to do that in this tutorial. All right, now instead of having this black background, I want to use a watercolor background. And I was able to find one of these out in the plus section of designbundles.com. And by the way, you can get a 7-day free trial of that. The link for that is in the description. So I downloaded that and unzipped it. And I'm going to pull this JPEG into my Photoshop document. It'll size it to the size of my canvas. And so I'm going to make it bigger to fill the canvas. I'll hold Option and Shift to resize it. I'm going to make it quite a bit bigger. And I would like the dark area to be on the right side so that the text shows up better against it. I'll hover outside of the corner of this handle, which will give me rotate, and I'll just rotate this around back here, maybe about there. I might even make it a little bit bigger. And I'll hit Enter or Return to commit my changes. So you can use any picture you want back here, but I would do a solid-ish background, nothing too crazy going on back there so you don't distract from your text and your picture. All right, now let's add some text. I'll hit T on my keyboard, which will take me to the text tool right over here. And I'm gonna click once, and it's really, really small, which is fine. I'll type, what does a, I'll get back on my move tool and then hit Command T. And make this quite a lot bigger. If you want to change the color, you can just click on this and then choose a new color and say okay. Now I'm going to hold Option or Alt and drag this layer down below it so that we have a copy. And then I'll get back on my move tool and just move it down holding shift. Now I'll hit T on my keyboard to get to my text tool. And I'll get into this by just kind of highlighting some of it and then hit Command A or Control A. And I'm going to type graphic designer. I'm going to change this font to alternate Gothic. And I want it a lot bigger, so I'm going to increase the size of my text by hitting Shift Command and then right caret. It's above the period. That's Shift Control right caret on a PC. So we'll make it quite a bit bigger. No, not that big. And then hold Option or Alt and use your down arrow to increase the leading a little bit. I'll get back on my move tool and just move this down. And now I'm going to Option or Alt drag this layer again. I'll get back on my move tool and I'll click and drag and hold Shift and Option. I'll hit T to get back on my text tool and highlight a little, Command A or Control A to select all. Now I'm going to hold Command down or Control on a PC, select all my text, and then move it up. Maybe hit Command T and resize it a little bit. And now I want maybe just a little underline here, so I'm going to hit B on my keyboard to get to my brushes. I'm going to choose a basic brush. This looks pretty good. And I want my smoothness to be 100. Now I need to start a new layer for this, so I'll click the New Layer button. I'm going to resize my cursor a little bit and just draw that in right there. Let me try that again. We'll make it a little bit thinner. Maybe rotate it a little. Okay, well this looks all right. Now you might notice that my coloring doesn't look that great with this background, so I'm going to add some color balance to this. I'll click on my photo layer and come down here to add a new adjustment layer, and we'll choose color balance. I'm just going to move this over a little bit. I'm going to increase the magenta a little bit, maybe the blue. Okay, and I think I match a little better now. All right, we'll get rid of that in properties. I probably went a little too far on that. So now I'm going to click on color balance and I'm going to hit Option Command G to make sure it only applies to that photo. And I'm going to take all these other photos and drop them behind the background. So they'll still be available to us, but we can turn them on and they won't cause a problem now. Now the last step is to export. So I'll come up here to File, Export, Export As, and we'll want to choose a PNG. We'll export this and I'll save it as YouTube thumbnail. So this is basically a template now. All we have to do is click and drag our photo and move it below the background. We can click and drag a new photo up, turn it on, and then maybe we'll move that over a little bit. And then we can come down here and change our text if we'd like. We could even rotate our background by hitting Command T, zooming out a little bit, and just switching it over to something a little different. So now it's got the same look and feel as the first thumbnail, which helps with branding and recognition and all that, but it is a different thumbnail. All right, if you like this video, please click the like button, and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.